guys. Merry Christmas Eve. I'm Griffin, and tonight we've got a special show for you. It's the Ghost of Paul Revere Christmas Eve Holiday Bonanza, streamed from our homes here in Maine and elsewhere. It's been a pretty crazy year, so we figured we'd have a little bit of fun with you. Play some of our favorite holiday songs, make some food, make some drinks, and hang out with our friends. So come, join us, won't you? As you get visited by four ghosts tonight, and our friends. I think it's gonna be a pretty good time. Hey Google, let's start the show.
Oh, good evening. I've got a little Christmas Eve story for you, if you'll listen. 'Twas the night before Christmas, pre-Oh Holy Night, as we all settled in by the warm internet light. We set up the tree, the garland and holly. We've hung up the stockings, and we're feeling quite jolly. We weren't able to get Santa, to our great dismay. He and his reindeer are busy, but this outfit slays. Oh, that's right, folks. My teeth are sunk deep into these Christmas traditions my kin and I keep. And because we're stuck in with nothing to do, and because that it's Christmas, we'll share them with you. Whatever you celebrate, no matter the weather, we're socially distant, but we're distant together. Though this year is different, and that hardly needs mention. We're glad that you're here, and we have your attention. And who is this we? Who else could be here? Maybe Belschnickel, or Rudolph the reindeer. Or maybe it's Krampus, or Elf on the Shelf. Why, it's our good friend Griffin, who looks like a young Santa himself. You know the young Claus I mean, from the old Rankin Bass. Their stop-motion productions. Those movies kicked ass. But back to the matter, we've got Griffin here, and not only just him, but the whole ghost of Paul Revere. We've got Max with his banjo, and Ben with his keys. We've got Chuck with those green eyes, oh, such a tease. We've got Jackson, my dude, with his slippery guitar, and I'll pop back in, I'll try not to go far, because tonight we've decided what we're going to do is take our Christmas Eve and share it with you. We'll play you some songs and toast to the season, or toast to whatever, you don't need a reason. But before we begin, I really must say, whether you are a Mainer or you're from away, that we can't wait to see you, and we'll do it up soon. And we'll stomp and we'll holler, and it won't be on Zoom. But until then, this'll do, and we'll still try to spread cheer, while we flip a tall bird to this absolute dumpster fire of a year. Now enough of that talk. Let's get merry and bright. Knock down your nog. Lend your pipe a light. For 'twas the night before Christmas, he said with a grin. Happy holidays to all. Let the show begin.
Run, run, Rudolph, Santa's got a meeting to tear. is Christmas. And what have you done? Another year over, and a new one just begun. And so this is Christmas.
Again for joining us. This is really incredible. I know that we're all stuck on the internet still, but the future's looking brighter every day. So happy holidays. I hope you're with your family or with your friends, whoever you can be with these holidays. I hope that you enjoy that time. We miss all of you dearly. And you know what? This entire night is about friends, and it's about people that I love and we all love, that we could all get together to do something a lot of fun. So I'd like to reintroduce my good buddy, Mr. Sean McCarthy. He's going to sing you a song called Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
Mm-hmm. yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. Next year all our troubles will be miles away.
Obviously, the holidays are a time of, you know, warmth and joy and festivity and all that. We're also, of course, in the coldest and darkest and hardest time of year. So I thought for my contribution to this whole thing, I'd play some of the grimmer, older, quieter, like Dickensian Christmas songs, which also tend to be some of my favorites. Anyway, here's some of those. Thank you.
toasting. Well, I hope you guys are enjoying it so far. We have a lot more coming up. I'd like to take time to introduce a good buddy of mine, Mr. Charles Gagne. He tends to steal the show whenever he shows up, and tonight's no different. In this new segment we like to call Charles Playing Charles.
That spirit of Christmas. when I hear you.
And now for something completely different.
Welcome to the holiday episode of Cooking with Sean, part of the Ghost of Paul Revere Christmas Eve special. Now, I'm not normally a baker, but I thought what better time to try than now. I'm going to be making hermits. Hermits are a molasses-based cookie normally found here in New England. It's been around here since the 1800s. I'm going to be using my Grammy Dell's recipe because that is my favorite. It's a perfect day for it, too. You're going to start off with 3 1/4 cups of flour, followed up by a cup of sugar. We've got 3/4 cup of shortening. Necessary is 1/2 cup of molasses. We need 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1 teaspoon of ground clove, 1 teaspoon of ground ginger, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of salt, you need 1/2 cup of lukewarm water, you need 1 tablespoon of butter, you need 1 teaspoon of vanilla, and you need 1 egg. We're gonna start this whole process out by creaming the shortening and the sugar together, which basically just means you're gonna mix it all together. I get to use this fancy KitchenAid mixer, but if you've got a regular mixer at home, or if you gotta do it the old fashioned method, get yourself a spatula and just beat the hell out of it. Now, we think they're called hermits because of the fact that they can keep so long compared to other cookies, but nobody really knows. Now, I'm going to add in about 1 tablespoon of sugar at a time, just to make sure it's incorporated into the shortening as well as it can be. I'll pick up the speed a little bit as we go. And done. You're going to want to make sure to take a break every once in a while just to scrape the sides of the bowl to make sure you're getting the good stuff. Once you get the goods back at the bottom of the bowl, we'll get her started all up again. While I leave it on for another minute, I'm going to dissolve that teaspoon of baking soda right into that 1/2 cup of lukewarm water. Next step, we're going to throw in our molasses. This is a key ingredient in these cookies. They can't be hermits without molasses. Then you're going to throw in your egg. And you're going to crank up the speed to beat it until it's nice and light. Then we're going to toss in that vanilla. While that's going, we're going to sift all of our dry ingredients together. With our flour, we've got those cloves. We've got that cinnamon. And we got that ground ginger. Last but not least, we'll also throw in the salt. And like I said, make sure you sift it all together, that way it's all incorporated and fine before you throw it into the mixing bowl. To do that, we'll throw in our nice little splash guard. We're going to add just a little bit at a time. We don't want to add it in too much. I'm using this cool spoon that Max made. Pretty nice. You're going to want to alternate the dry ingredients with some of that water that we dissolved the baking soda in earlier. And then some more of the dry ingredients and some more of the water until they're all gone. Once it's incorporated fully, you're going to put in that tablespoon of butter. It'll help if it's soft, but you don't want it warm. And I'll turn it up a little bit. I wonder how fast this goes. Anyway, you're going to want to grease down a cookie tray. And then spread the mixture out into even strips. Bring it on over to the oven that's preheated at 375. And throw them on in. They should only take about 10 minutes to cook, so we've got about 10 minutes right now. We can look out at this beautiful snowstorm and finally bring up the point that we haven't made this like the Great British Baking Show at all. No soggy bottoms here. So once it's all done, 10 minutes have elapsed, you'll take out your cookies and they're not supposed to look like that. I think I should have used 2 baking sheets. Perfect time to go over a McCarthy family holiday favorite, Lose Your Lunch Punch. Sometimes when the cookies don't go, you need a drip pick-me-up. So you're going to take some orange juice. In this case, we got a cup of orange juice, so we're making 2 cocktails right now. You're going to take a half a cup of grapefruit juice. I'm not sure when Lose Your Lunch Punch became part of the McCarthy family tradition at Christmas, but I can guess where it got its name from. Anyway, next up you're going to take 2 teaspoons of grenadine. Now what this makes right here is for about 2 cocktails, but you can do as much as you like. You can throw it in the orange juice jug, keep it in the fridge or out in the snow all day. Perfect. Of course, you're going to need some vodka, so grab your tipple, grab the juice. You know what? It's Christmas. If you're old enough to drink, you're old enough to decide how much you get. And there. Now what we're going to do is just stir it up so it gets a little chilly with the ice that's already in there. But like I said, if you got a handful of snow, that'll work too. Grab yourself a glass. Throw some rocks in there. And then pour yourself a drink. You deserve it. You figured out what to do with the cookies. You're just gonna cut them. They're just gonna be a little bigger. It's fine. As the snow softly falls, the bakers make their way back to the tent with their final signature bake. That's right, folks. We did it. We made Grammy Dell's Hermit Cookies. Thank you for joining in. I hope you give them a shot and you like them. Back to the special now.
This Christmas, give the gift of music to your family and friends. ABC Concert Music has 3 terrific ideas for you. A 1988 subscription ticket to the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra, Choose from a 10 right down to a 4 concert series. A youth text book for only $25. Books of 5 vouchers may be redeemed by the 25s and under on concert nights for the best remaining seats in the house.
The Good at Losing Everything vinyl LP book.
A marvelous coffee table book for $25. For prices and purchase details for these great gifts, phone 640-3339 now.
You know, not all of us are in New England for the holiday this year. Our good buddy Jackson's out in New York, but he's still got a little song for you tonight. Enjoy. Boy, that was a lovely little thing by Mr. Kintrillo, wasn't it? Oh, holy night indeed. You got me going through the old holiday box. Full of history. Little mementos. Years past. Wow. Well, I haven't seen this in a minute. Boy, this is from back in 1992. Was a famous year, and I did this world famous movie called Satan's Ravine. Satan's Ravine. I thought maybe we could take a gander at the trailer tonight. You know, in the holiday spirit.
Time when a ski race could still save Christmas. One man, his invisible snowman friend, three skittles to keep the Christmas glory carols of glory safe. Meatball Max, Charlie the Snowman, join forces yet again.
Devil's Army is old, man. Satan's Ravine.
Satan's Ravine. Fast pace, with the breakneck, downhill there the other decade.
There's only one way to go from here, and that's down.
Coming next December.
This is actually one of my favorite holiday songs. It was written by, allegedly this is written by Henry VIII. But I feel feel like it was also during that time when, like, kings could just take credit for stuff. So, who knows? But anyway, it's really old. And I love it very much.
You know, Charlie's song got me thinking, there are a lot of great Christmas movies. Of course, National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, and Die Hard, although I don't consider Die Hard a Christmas movie because it came out in July. Technicality. My favorite happens to be Emmett Otter's Jug Band Christmas. And as we patiently wait for the theatrical release of
Satan's Reign,
I'd like to play you a song from Emmett Otter's called Our World. Come. Join me in the basement. Thank you.
Special time of year, and I thought that the best present I could give everybody was to make a gift that keeps on giving all year round, that's for sure. It's my favorite drink made by the legendary bard of Portland Brewskies. It's the Joe Moran. Fun fact, Sean and I are only allowed to have four of them. You know, people say that Ruskies is the ones who invented the Joe Moran. I've heard differently. I heard it was Solomon's favorite drink. And I heard there was a fourth wise man who brought the recipe of the Joe Moran to the manger. But unfortunately never made it because he had a couple.
And here we go. First thing you're going to need is a little bit of coffee. You know what? This is Queen Anne Roasters. He's awesome. He makes violins. This is the Christmas blend. I like the whiskey blend too. But you should get some. Then you're going to brew it up. My coffee maker's broken, so I'm using a French press right now. It's so fancy and so French. Next, grab yourself that Jameson, the Irish Mist, the Bailey's, ooh, sweet creamy beige, and that Kahlua, because we're going to start making this drink. Next, pour yourself a little bit of Jameson into a 2-ounce shot glass and put that in the pint glass. You know what? It's always good to take one for luck. Sometimes two. Then we're going to put 2 ounces of that Irish Mist in there, 2 ounces of Bailey's, all going in the pint glass. Stir it up a little bit and then add that sweet, sweet bean juice. Oh, glorious coffee. And lastly, we're going to add a little bit of whip on top. I don't take mine with whip, but some people do. Now to top this whole beautiful thing off, let's do a little bit of Kahlua drizzle. I just drizzled all over the floor, but it doesn't matter. It's delicious. It's fine. Drink it.
And it's as simple as that. A Joe Moran. It's exceedingly good.
Do you like Joe Morans? Yeah, I do too.
Fun fact, keep your coffee in the fridge overnight, throw some ice in it, you can have an ice Joe. They're just as good. Merry Christmas.
Hey guys. I'm gonna play you my favorite Christmas song. It's called Fairy Tale of New York. It was Christmas Eve, babe, in the drunk tank, an old man said to me, won't see another one. And then he sang a song. That rare old Mountain Dew, I turned my face away and dreamed about you. Got on a lucky one, came in 18-1. I've got a feeling this year's for me and you. So happy Christmas, I love you, baby, I can see a better time when all our dreams will come true. They got cars big as bars, they've got rivers of gold, where the wind blows right through you, it's no place for the old. When you first took my hand on that cold Christmas Eve, well, you promised me Broadway was waiting for me. You're handsome, you're pretty, queen of New York City. When the band finished playing, they howled out for more. Sinatra was swinging, all the drunks they were singing. We kissed on the corner and danced through the night. And the boys of the NYPD choir were singing Galway Bay. And the bells were ringing out on Christmas Day.
Normally we'd go to the second verse here, but since it's got a word I really, really don't like in it, I'm going to skip it. Moving on. I could have been someone, but so could anyone. You took my dreams from me when I first found you, but I kept them with me, babe. I placed them with my own, can't make it all alone. I built my dreams around you. And the boys of the NYPD choir still singing Galway Bay. And the bells were ringing out on Christmas Day. I love you, baby. I can see a better day when all our dreams will come true.
Stars at night. My favorite key marker is Hawaii. say Merry Christmas to you. My Licky Mocker is the theme to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas Day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where pine trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright. The sun will shine all day and all the stars at night. My Licky Mocker is the main way to say Merry Christmas. A very Merry Christmas, a very, very Merry, Merry Christmas to you.
Well, it's about that time again. We only have one more surprise and treat for you this Christmas Eve. I hope everyone has an extremely merry and safe Christmas tomorrow, or whatever holiday you celebrate. Thank you for spending tonight with us, the Ghost. You know, I cannot wait for next year. I cannot wait to be on stage again with my friends playing music for everyone. And it'll happen. You just have to be a little patient. But until then, we get to keep doing fun stuff like this. Thank you so much for supporting us throughout the entire year. It has been incredible. It has been incredibly hard to stay afloat, but we are doing it. Thanks to you guys, everybody on Patreon. You truly are incredible supporters of The Ghost, and we don't forget it. So, as a special treat, here is Mr. Spencer Albee and all the ghosts sing you a little song by Mr. Paul McCartney.
The mood is right, the spirit's up, we're here tonight, and that's enough. We're simply having a wonderful Christmas time. We're simply having a wonderful Christmas time. The party's on, the feeling's here, that only comes this time of year. We're simply having a wonderful Christmas time. This time, the choir of children sing their song. Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong.
Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Christmas time. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays, everybody. We really hope to see you soon.
Happy holidays, everybody. Miss you very much. Hope to see you soon.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays to all you Ghost of Paul Revere fans. I'm Josh Knight, the band's agent, and I just wanted to say thanks for hanging in with the band this year. It's been a long one not being able to play all of our normal gigs out there. Thanks for coming to the new ones, like the drive-ins and the social distance concerts. It's kind of an experiment, and I think it worked. Hopefully next year we'll get this band back out to you inside those clubs and theaters. So happy holidays, happy new year, take care.
Happy holidays, everybody. It's been a tough year, but hang in there.
Happy holidays, everyone.
Happy holidays, everybody, from the Ghost of Paul Revere Accounting Office. Thank you so much for your help this year, and everybody that came out to support the band with the live streams, with the drive-in concerts, with Patreon. We quite literally could not have done this year and made it through this year without your help. So thank you, everybody, and happy holidays.
Thank you guys so much for joining in tonight. Merry Christmas. We can't wait to see you again. Love you from our family to yours.
Happy holidays from the Ghost fam. We love you and wishing you the best, merriest season. Mwah.
Happy holidays, Ghost of Paul Revere fans. From our team to all of you and your families, much love, thanks, and support for all the support this year. It's been a long one. We're getting through it together. We couldn't be happier to have you in our lives. Happy holidays.
Wishing you a very happy holiday season from the Ghost of Paul Revere organization. I wanted to thank everyone personally for sticking with us through this crazy year. It's been a pretty wild ride, but it's been really fun actually putting together some of these special things that we wouldn't normally do, like the drive-in shows and the streams and all the Patreon content. And we're really looking forward to seeing all of you out in person at an actual show sometime in 2021. So until then, stay safe, happy holidays. We'll see you real soon.
Oh, hello everyone, Chuck here from the Ghost of Paul Revere. I'd like to wish you and yours a happy, healthy holiday season full of merriment and joy. I personally cannot wait to see you all at a show real soon.
Hey guys, happy holidays. Thanks so much for tuning in. It means the world to us to have your support. We're unbelievably thankful. So thank you. Miss you. Looking forward to seeing you in the new year. Okay. Good night.
Amazing, that spirit of Christmas.